tyres and inner tubes are the most cost-effective upgrade you can make to your bike. And in this video, I'm going to prove it. Whew, at least I hope so anyway. So before you throw your old tyres and inner tubes away, I'm going to conduct a simple test. And the great thing is, you're going to be able to test your own kind of stuff like this at home. Hey, don't forget your tyres. Hey, you want these? Oh, and if you enjoy this kind of content, if you haven't subscribed already, please do, because it helps make future videos even better. Most bikes won't come with premium tyres, and they'll often have a standard butyl inner tube like this. But even if you've bought a top spec bike like this, fitted with good quality tyres, it's still likely to be fitted with these standard butyl inner tubes. However, upgrade to a latex or a TPU or polyurethane inner tube, you're going to be able to reduce the weight and reduce the rolling resistance, which is great because it's going to help you ride significantly faster. The TPU tubes are lighter than the latex tubes. However, in all of the studies that I have seen, the latex tube offers the lowest in rolling resistance. And seeing as the rolling resistance has a greater impact on the performance of our bikes than the weight, it should, in theory, be the fastest option. If you upgrade your tyres at the same time as your inner tubes, you can reduce that rolling resistance even more, meaning you can ride at the same speed for even less effort. And when upgrading your tyres to more premium ones, they're going to be lighter weights, they're going to offer improved grip and improved puncture resistance. However, if you take that to the extreme, some super lightweight tyres can be more prone to punctures, leaving you and your tyres deflated. You see what I did there? To show you the difference between the two setups, I'm going to be using these, a set of smart rollers. Fitted to my bike currently is a 28mm tyre from the Eurobike. Down beside me is a 28mm tyre, the Pirelli P0 Race, their premium flagship tyre. Going to have three inner tubes, the standard butyl one, a latex and a TPU. Then we're going to test each tyre riding at a consistent speed for a time of 5 minutes. Then using my power meter pedals, I can record the average power it takes to ride at that consistent speed. To monitor my speed, I've got a sensor fitted to the rear wheel, and then I'm going to ride my most consistent and controlled effort for those 5 minute blocks as possible to see if there really is a measurable difference or if my efforts are going to be wasted, I'm going to be none the wiser. And to try and make this test as fair as possible, I'm trying to limit as many of the different variables, so the only difference is the tyres and inner tubes. Let's get to it now, I'm warmed up. Right, test done. Save all that valuable data. Right, all I need to do now is jump off the bike, get downloading all of this information, collate it into a table, and then, you know what's coming next? We're gonna discuss the results. See you there. So the results are as follows. Our budget tyre, when ridden at 30 kilometers an hour for 5 minutes with a butyl inner tube, we have an average speed of 30.4 kilometers an hour at 215 watts. Add in a latex inner tube to that, we've got 30.3 kph, 198 watts. And then finally, the TPU tube, 30.3 kilometers an hour, was 200 watts. So we're upgrading the budget tyre to a latex tube, which is costing in the region of around £12. You've managed to reduce and save 17 watts of rolling resistance on our budget tyre. Then if you were to upgrade to a TPU tube at a cost of say £25, you're gonna save 15 watts compared to the lowest of our butyl inner tube, which is, you know, slightly less than what I was expecting. Move forward to our premium tyre. Again, tested with the same method, ridden at 30 kilometers an hour for 5 minutes. With the butyl inner tube, we've got an average speed of 30.3 kph, 170 watts. Move to the latex inner tube, 30.4 kilometers an hour, and 161 watts. And finally, the TPU tube, 30.3 kph, 167 watts. So by upgrading from the Eurobike tyre to a premium race tyre that's costing in the region of £55, using the butyl inner tube saved a whopping 45 watts. Now that is a huge saving. But I've kind of got to say that the Eurobike tyre really is at the bottom end of the price list when it comes to quality, rolling resistance, and all sorts of aspects like that. And I feel that in reality, we should expect a slightly reduced watt saving. Now, add in a latex tube to our premium tyre for £12. We're saving an additional 9 watts of rolling resistance. Then add a TPU tube in at a cost of £25. It's saving just 3 watts compared to the cheaper butyl inner tube. That's definitely not as much as I was expecting. Now, in this instance, I used a P0 race tyre from Pirelli, which costs £55. But I have got to say, there are lots of other premium race tyres out there. But the beauty of showing you this testing method is that it gives you the option of testing stuff like this at home using the products and equipment that you're familiar with or perhaps that you're looking to upgrade to. Now, in addition to all the data and results we've got here, the difference in switching from the budget tyre to the premium one was noticeable in feel before having seen any of that data, and that is reassuring to know as well. So by spending in the region of £150 on 2 tyres and 2 inner tubes, it means you could save about 600 grams and close to 75 watts in rolling resistance if you went from one of the slowest to the fastest setups. Now, that is the kind of upgrade that people might try and expect to get from upgrading to a carbon fiber frame, but all of that is at a fraction of the cost just when you're using your tyres and inner tubes. So there you have it. What are you waiting for? Get testing your own setups indoors, at home, and then look to upgrade your tyres and inner tubes. Hope you found this video helpful. If you have, give it a big thumbs up and let me know in the comments section down below not only what you thought of my little experiment today, if you're gonna try this at home. Right, I'm off to get this sweaty kit off. See you later.